For Jacob my servant's sake, and Israel mine elect, I have even called thee by thy name. I have surnamed thee, though thou hast not known me. I am the Lord, and there is none else. There is no God beside me. I girded thee, though thou hast not known me, that they may know from the rising of the sun and from the west that there is none beside me. I am the Lord, and there is none else. I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things.
If the people of the Most High could overcome idolatry, a major shift would take place in the lives of the indigenous Black people all over the world. The downfall of the Israelites and the indigenous Black people is idolatry. The kingdom of darkness used idolatry to cause a separation between the Most High and His people. The scripture said, "Sin separate us from the Most High."
But your iniquities have separated between you and your God, and your sins have hid His face from you, that He will not hear.
If the indigenous people are separated from the Most High, they lose the protection of the Most High. With the Most High out of the way, the kingdom of darkness can have its way with the indigenous Black people. The sin of idolatry is placing an unworthy deity in the position of the Most High in your life. Satan knows the ultimate sin is idolatry. The Most High said to His people, the Israelites, "There should be no other gods before me." That is the first commandment.
Thou shalt have no other gods before me.
The little gods are destroying the indigenous people all over the world. Israelites, it is important that you understand the strategies the kingdom of darkness use against you. If you cannot recognize the darts Satan is sending your way, you will never overcome the strongholds Satan and his angels place in your life. The indigenous Black people are oppressed all over the world. Many do not know why. Idolatry is the number one sin against the indigenous Black people. From the beginning up until now, the indigenous people practice idolatry. The Israelites are scattered all over the world due to the sin of idolatry. The Israelites would forsake the Elohim of Israel and worship the gods of the heathens they live among. Until this day, many Israelites are forsaking the Elohim of Israel and worshiping foreign gods. The scripture said the Israelites would worship gods made from the hands of men, gods made from wood and stone.
And there ye shall serve gods, the work of men's hands, wood and stone, which neither see nor hear nor eat nor smell.
The scriptures went on to say the gods the Israelites are serving in the land of their captivity, their ancestors do not know these gods.
And the Lord shall scatter thee among all people, from the one end of the earth even unto the other. And there thou shalt serve other gods, which neither thou nor thy fathers have known, even wood and stone.
Israelites, if our ancestors do not know the gods this generation of Israelites are serving, then the graven image the beast system parade in our faces as the Elohim of Israel for multiple generations is not the Elohim of our fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. These little gods that our people mistake for the Elohim of Israel is causing our people and the indigenous Black people who accept the Most High as their God to stumble.
And they took the bullock which was given them, and they dressed it, and called on the name of Baal from morning even until noon, saying, "O Baal, hear us!" But there was no voice, nor any that answered. And they leaped upon the altar which was made. And it came to pass at noon that Elijah mocked them and said, "Cry aloud, for he is a god. Either he is talking, or he is pursuing, or he is in a journey. A peradventure he sleepeth, and must be awaked."
Accepting and worshiping the graven image that has the likeness of the children of the watchers is idolatry. There are many indigenous Black people who accept the false Messiah as the Elohim of Israel. They worship this idol in religion. Due to this major mistake, the indigenous people are suffering all over the world. You can find altars raised to the graven image the world accepted as the Elohim of Israel in every nation. Even the indigenous people living in the remote places of this world know about white Jesus. Yet their conditions never improve. It seems to me the so-called gospel has made its way around the world if the indigenous black people dwelling in the remote places know who white Jesus is. How come the end is not here, like the scripture said?
And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come.
Israelites and indigenous black people, the word that is supposed to be preached all over the world is happening now in the awakening. Many are hearing the truth for the first time. Once everyone has a chance to hear the truth the Most High has sent into the world, the end will come. Many are now discovering who the true Hebrews are. History is finally correcting itself. Satan and the workers of iniquity in high places are oppressing the truth on social media and everywhere they could control the narrative. The workers of iniquity cannot allow this truth to spread. Regardless to the censorship, the gospel will reach everyone. The times of the heathens will end.
And they shall fall by the edge of the sword, and shall be led away captive into all nations. And Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled.
There is no stopping prophecy. The words of the Most High will fulfill what He sent it to do. The words of the Most High will not return to Him void. All scriptures will be fulfilled.
God is not a man that He should lie, neither the Son of Man that He should repent. Hath He said, and shall He not do it? Or hath He spoken, and shall He not make it good?
Israelites, it is imperative that you understand the Most High is the Elohim to Israel. Yah identify Himself as the God of our fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The scriptures also refer to the Most High as the God of Israel.
Moreover, He said, I am the God of thy father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look upon God. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge, Selah.
I never once heard the Most High refer to Himself as the God of the world. The reason it is important that you understand that Yah is the Elohim of Israel, the kingdom of darkness has given the scriptures a new meaning in religion. For Satan to receive the worship he lusts after and assume the identity of the Most High, he had to make everyone feel included. That is why John 3:16 is accepted in the beast system as the foundation to religion.
For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
The synagogue of Satan has truly misled many with the infamous John 3:16 scripture. Today there are strangers claiming the Israelite bloodline because they were misled in religion to believe they are spiritual Israel. Religion embedded into the minds of the people that the Most High is an Elohim to all. The Most High is not a father to the wicked, nor to anyone who transgresses His laws. The Most High is not a God to all. There are many people who reject the Elohim of Israel. The synagogue of Satan pushed false doctrines to get the people to accept the beast culture in religion. Remember, religion is not of the Most High. Satan is the father to all religion. The indigenous heathens had their own gods they worshiped. Throughout the scriptures, you can read how the Most High destroyed the indigenous heathens and their gods. Before the Israelites could inhabit the promised land, they had to get rid of the inhabitants on the land and remove their high places. The Most High would command His people not to take on the ways of the pagans.
Then you shall drive out all the inhabitants of the land from before you, and destroy all their pictures, and destroy all their molten images, and quite pluck down all their high places. But the cities of these people, which the Lord thy God doth give thee for an inheritance, thou shalt save alive nothing that breatheth, but thou shalt utterly destroy them, namely the Hittites, and the Amorites, the Canaanites, and the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites, as the Lord thy God hath commanded thee, that they teach you not to do after all their abominations which they have done unto their gods. So should ye sin against the Lord your God.
It was important for the Israelites to destroy the high places of the heathens and to destroy the heathens from the land. If they do not comply with the commands of the Most High, the heathens would become a thorn to them. The Most High knew his people could be easily influenced to follow the pagans. That is why he instructed them to destroy everything. This generation is no different from the previous generations. They are following the very people that oppress and enslave them. They support and uphold the heathens that destroy them.
But if ye will not drive out the inhabitants of the land from before you, then it shall come to pass that those which ye let remain of them shall be pricks in your eyes and thorns in your sides, and shall vex you in the land wherein ye dwell.
Israelites, you must follow the Most High's instructions. The Most High did not destroy the heathens for no reason. Idolatry is an abomination in the sight of the Most High. The reason the Elohim of Israel became a god to the world was through religious doctrines. Throughout the scriptures, the Most High is speaking to his people, the Israelites.
James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greeting.
The workers of iniquity in the beast system misled many to believe the scriptures are speaking to everyone. Until this day, the heathens worship and serve their gods. The indigenous people need to understand that you cannot serve two masters. You cannot serve the Elohim of Israel and devils. Serving the little gods of the heathens is giving the glory of the Most High to the devils. You must choose.
Ye cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils. Ye cannot be partakers of the Lord's table and of the table of devils.
The beast culture have an abundance of little gods for the people to worship and serve. Satan created many faith and denominations to cater to everyone's preference in the beast culture. The indigenous people lost in the beast system are deep into idolatry. The beast culture is nothing but idolatry. Television, movies, music, to the food you eat and the places you visit for entertainment are structured to initiate you into idol worship. The celebrity lifestyle many people lust after is idol worship. There are people who worship these people as if the celebrity could save their lives. The so-called celebrity do nothing but take from you. In addition, falsify who they are. A foundation that is built from lies, you can trace its roots to the kingdom of darkness. Satan is the father of lies. Idolatry comes in many forms. Worshipping a statue and creating idols with wood and stones are not the only form of idolatry. Worshipping idols in religion is not the only way the indigenous people exalt the little gods. Your children, husband, and wife can be your idol. Over the years, I have seen how an unclean spirit is contaminating the awakening by increasing the pride in some indigenous black men to have the indigenous black woman worship them. Repent. The Most High is not sharing his glory with anyone.
I am the Lord. That is my name. And my glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images.
The love of money is idolatry, vanity. Your job and lusting after the daughters and sons of the watchers is idolatry. Anything that takes first place in your life is idolatry. First place is reserved for the Most High. If you put your job, family, and other worldly possessions over the Most High, you are not worthy of the Most High.
He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me.
I hope you're beginning to see how deep idol worship runs in the beast system. This generation have the zeal to rise against the kingdom of darkness, but not according to knowledge. Our ancestors fought just like this generation is rising against their enemies to preserve their culture. The kingdom of darkness have deceived many indigenous black people to fight independently from the Most High. In addition, the God they place their trust in is an idol that can't do anything for them. That is the reason the indigenous people go around in circles. The awakening is about introducing the people of the Most High to the God of their fathers, the Elohim of Israel. You will not find the Most High in religion. If this generation would destroy the little gods of their parents, like Abraham destroyed his father's idols, the indigenous people would triumph over their enemies. And Abram came to his father's house and saw 12 gods standing there in their temples. And the anger of Abram was kindled when he saw these images in his father's house. And Abram said, "As the Lord liveth, these images shall not remain in my father's house. So shall the Lord who created me do unto me if in 3 days' time I do not break them all." And when Abram saw all these things, his anger was kindled against his father. And he hastened and took a hatchet in his hand and came unto the chamber of the gods, and he broke all his father's gods. The beast culture has shamed many into silence. Speaking against the little gods leads to severe consequences in the beast system. Where are the lions of Judah? Roar against these little gods that defy the Elohim of Israel. This generation will subdue their enemies if they get rid of the little gods. Yah has given us power over the entire kingdom of darkness. The indigenous black people need to tap into that power to witness the Elohim of Israel's sovereignty in the beast system.
Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you.
Israelites and indigenous black people, idolatry and sorcery goes hand in hand. You cannot have idolatry without witchcraft and sorcery. Idolatry and witchcraft are brother and sister. The powers hiding behind idolatry is rooted in witchcraft and sorcery. It is through sorcery the people interact with their gods. The spirits hiding behind the little gods are demons, unclean spirits, Satan, and the entire kingdom of darkness. The scripture said the things which the heathens sacrifice, they sacrifice to devils and not to the Most High.
But I say that the things which the Gentiles sacrifice, they sacrifice to devils and not to God. And I would not that ye should have fellowship with devils.
When you see the workers of iniquity in religion doing their altar calls and sacrificing to their gods, these sacrifices are being made to idols. Do not be fooled, Israelites and indigenous black people. Behind every altar in religion is a devil. Religion is the gateway to sorcery. The leaders in religion are high-level workers of iniquity. They know how to interact with unclean spirits and how to use demonic powers. That is how witchcraft contributes to idolatry. The scriptures reveal to us in the book of Enoch that the watchers, the fallen angels, taught mankind witchcraft and sorcery. Samjaza taught enchantments and root cutting, the resolving of enchantments, astrology, the constellation, the knowledge of the clouds, the signs of the earth, the signs of the sun, and the course of the moon. And as men perished, they cried, and their cry went up to heaven. And the whole earth has been corrupted through the works that were taught by Azazel. To him ascribe all sin. In this lost generation, there are people who worship Azazel, despite the scripture saying, "To Azazel all sin is ascribed." I have seen disturbing videos that are not censored on YouTube of people encouraging others to worship Azazel. They get away with it because they disguise their belief behind religion. In addition, the beast culture welcomes lawlessness. Indigenous people all over the world, get out of the house of bondage. Do not be partakers with them.
And I heard another voice from heaven saying, "Come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues."
The first thing the seed of the serpent did when they colonized the indigenous people all over the world was introduce them to religion and their many idols. Heathens worship many gods. Do not be surprised if a heathen accept the Elohim of Israel. To them, the Most High is another deity to worship. Remember, a heathen worship many gods. The high-level workers of iniquity use sorcery to make the sheep believe they are interacting with the Most High in religion. That is why the church is full of workers of iniquity, disguising themselves as ministers of righteousness.
Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works.
The workers of iniquity sacrifice the sheep to their idols in religion. They feed their idols the souls of the sheep in their congregation. The indigenous people trapped in religion believe they are interacting with the true Elohim of Israel. However, they are interacting with familiar spirits. Familiar spirits are unclean spirits that know you and your family. Familiar spirits travel in your family's bloodline for multiple generations. That is how they are familiar with you. The familiar spirits tell the workers of iniquity about your life. By doing this, the sheep are deceiving to believing the false prophets revealing their life story is operating by the Holy Spirit. The truth is they are operating with demonic powers. It is time for the indigenous people to recognize that they are participating in idol worship in the pagan church and in the beast system. The indigenous people have taken on the sorcery they have learned and use it against themselves to further destroy their people. You cannot overcome evil using evil. I noticed that the indigenous black people never use sorcery against the powers that oppress them. However, they have no problem using sorcery against their brethren. The scripture said it best, Satan cannot cast out Satan. If Satan casts out Satan, he would be divided against himself. How then could his kingdom stand?
And if Satan cast out Satan, he is divided against himself. How shall then his kingdom stand?
Israelites, it is important that you meditate on the scriptures to get a complete understanding of what the scriptures is revealing. The scripture said, if Satan casts out Satan, he would be divided against himself. If he is divided against himself, how can his kingdom stand? The indigenous black people are the most divided groups of people. Even in the awakening, there is division. Israelites, how can we stand if we are divided against ourselves? The beast system has taught the indigenous black people to have a self-centered mentality, the save myself mindset. I often hear indigenous black men say they will not protect the indigenous black woman, while others say they are obligated to protect their wives and family only. To those of you with this mentality, I hope the members of your family do not come across men who share the same view of saving the members of their immediate family only if they ever find themselves in a situation the men in their family are not present to help. Get rid of the self-centered mindset. The selfish mentality is working against the indigenous black people. Remember, the Israelite bloodline is a family, making other Israelites a member of your immediate family. A bloodline consists of a family clan. There are no outsiders in a bloodline. The Israelite bloodline started with Jacob, the progenitor, and Jacob's sons, the head of each tribe. There were no outsiders who contribute to the foundation of the Israelite bloodline. Do not be fooled with the false doctrine from religion. Sorcery is dangerous. The Most High has zero tolerance for his people that practice sorcery and witchcraft.
A man also, or woman that hath a familiar spirit, or that is a wizard, shall surely be put to death. They shall stone them with stones. Their blood shall be upon them.
Sorcery can damage a person and their entire bloodline if the victim is not knowledgeable about the spirit realm. Many people's dreams, their purpose, their talent, and life has been affected by sorcery. If you're an Israelite, you are affected by sorcery. A good way to know if sorcery is affecting you, sorcery show up in the form of generational curses. Your dream life would reveal if sorcery and witchcraft is the foundation to your problems. Unfortunately for the indigenous black people, idolatry, sorcery, and witchcraft is the root to your problems. The kingdom of darkness use witchcraft and sorcery against you, and the indigenous people use sorcery against themselves. Religion is a disguise for idolatry and sorcery in the beast system. Even outside religion, many indigenous people practice idolatry and sorcery. Indigenous black people all over the world, there is only one God, the Elohim of Israel. He can grant you the desires of your heart. There is no need to worship many idols and participate in diabolical rituals to get short-term blessings from the kingdom of darkness. Do not let the kingdom of darkness deceive you with the little gods pretending to be the Elohim of Israel. if the indigenous people can rid themselves from idolatry and sorcery, their lives would turn around instantly. You must recognize the diabolical system you live in. The beast culture is set up to keep you in sin. Do not allow the little gods to have first place in your life. The Most High can provide for his people. Do not let the synagogue of Satan be your teacher in the times we're living in. The indigenous people spend too much time listening to the lies of the disciples of Satan that is pushing them away from the Elohim of Israel into the arms of devils. Let the Most High be your teacher. There is only one Elohim of Israel, and you will not find him in religion. Israelites and indigenous people, get to know the Most High in the awakening. Do not forsake the true Elohim of Israel in the final hour.
Now therefore fear the Lord, and serve him in sincerity and in truth. And put away the gods which your fathers served on the other side of the flood and in Egypt, and serve ye the Lord. And if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom ye will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites, in whose land ye dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And the people answered and said, God forbid that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods.